Every train is equipped with a braking system to bring it to a stop. However, the mastermind of this system is the distributor valve, DV, as this device controls the entire brake operation. This is why it is called the brain of the brake system. This is a requested video, and we will explore the parts of DV and the functions. This is a DV distributor valve. There are different types of DVs which vary based on the company. This is one example of a DV. Only these parts are DV. The remaining components are part of a universal common area so that all kinds of models can be set here. This is DV's common bracket area. If we remove all parts, it is the structure of a DV. It consists of R charger. The function of an R charger is to charge the DV, and a hand lever is used to isolate the DV. This is choke cover. DV top cover. Bottom cover with quick release valve. A quick release valve's lever is used to release the brake cylinder pressure. It is operated manually during emergencies. Front and side cover. In a twin pipe system, the FP air charges the auxiliary reservoir and the BP air charges the DV. Let's understand how this DV works. Here, the brake pipe BP operates at a lower pressure, typically around 5 kilograms per square centimeter, compared to the feed pipe FP, which maintains 6 kilograms per square centimeter. The distributor valve DV is designed with internal passages and valves that enable air from the BP to flow into and charge the control reservoir. This control reservoir has a specific capacity of 6 liters in goods train. The primary function of the DV is to detect changes in brake pipe BP pressure, initiating brake application when pressure drops or increases. When the BP pressure subsequently drops, the air pressure trapped inside the control reservoir remains at its original higher reference level, which means CR pressure would not change. This leads to a pressure differential inside the DV, as it senses that the CR pressure is now greater than the BP pressure. This differential causes the DV's internal mechanism, including its diaphragms, pistons, to operate. The diaphragm is essentially a flexible, disc-shaped membrane that allows the auxiliary reservoir air pressure to flow into the brake cylinder. To understand this matter, you can see this animation. As a result, the DV allows the auxiliary reservoir air pressure to flow into the brake cylinder. The brake cylinder piston moves outwards, causing the brake shoes mounted on the brake beams to come into contact with the wheels. Friends, this video focused only on the distributor valve's DV function. For the full train brake system, see the end screen. And if you think this video is helpful, please share a like and comment. Thank you.